Hello and welcome to a full 2021 month by month energy and star sign reading, or a month by month full breakdown. So what we will do, what we will do is we look at your star sign, your individual star sign, month by month by month, and see what we can ascertain about 2021. To give you, in a way, not only a better idea of what's to come, but also hopefully equip you by giving you a heads up with ideas how to prepare, or it's probably the best way to say it, how to prepare for situations that may arise. Okay, what will happen is this. As you know, if you are a subscriber or a regular viewer, everything has an overall energy. And so before we go into your star sign and look at months by months by months what's going on, we will still have to look at the overall energy, which is what we're doing now. Now, the overall energy for 2021 applies to all star signs. So should you be a person that says, I'm that star sign, and then I'm going to watch this for my friend who is that star sign, you will notice that the overall energy video, this little clip before we go into the individual star signs, has been used for all the 12 star signs, because the overall energy simply doesn't change from star sign to star sign. What does change is obviously the energy within the star sign. Speaking of which, the monthly videos that we do, I should probably rephrase that, the weekly videos that I normally record with or without guests will continue, because as nice as this is to have a look at projecting based on the energy that the guides give us, when we do a weekly video, it is a tad more specific and maybe a tad deeper. So don't miss this. Please subscribe, please share, if that makes sense. So, and now we're looking at the overall energy for 2021. Since this is a long year, we're gonna break this up a little. So we're looking into what the energy of the year is actually going to be like, and see what the guides tell us, because it might just change again with the seasons. And then we look into all the other things, like, you know, what can you expect with regards to any business ventures you want to undertake, love, and then whatever else the guides bring up, if that makes sense. So let's have a look at what we can expect from 2021 to begin with, if that makes sense, right? Let's have a look. Wow. Okay. 2021, energetically speaking, feels, or will be, actually, much better than 2020. Well, that's easy, because 2020, by all accounts, was absolute shit. Right? So here's what the guys tell us about 2020. What they're asking us to do is to remember that as someone spiritual, you will have realized already that you create your energy. And if you make life the best it can be, that also filters down to anyone and everyone you meet. And that's what the guides are saying to you. In 2021, new portals will actually open. This will be a much more spiritual year. This will be a year where we connect much better to our guides, which is also needed, because don't be a sheeple. Seriously, pay attention, feel what's going on the planet, right? And bring your energy to the world to counterbalance any panic that you see around you, you know, the negativity that is sort of unfortunately happening in this world. Really, really important, but new doors will be opening. Really, really important. And when new doors are open, you still have to decide whether or not you want to walk through. And that's what the guides are saying. Be a bit of a wild card in 2021. Try new things because they will be rewarding and you will be rewarded, if that makes sense. It sounds a bit weird, but that's just how my guides phrase it, for your bravery. So, and then the most important thing as the energy for 2021 is for all of us, including myself, everybody, you know, it's the overall energy, you know, is to, this is what the card says, and I think it's quite nice, surrender to the sweetness of life. So you create your own energy, keep your energy high, love life, embrace life, and bring that energy to 2021. It's not really rocket science, but what they're saying to you is, or to us is, and we will have a look, obviously, a little bit deeper into 2021 in a minute, but because the overall energy tells us that it is up to us individually to bring about an energy shift, it's not the easiest thing to do. And where do you start? You start with yourself. You start with saying like, yay, life is great. And you do all your weird things that crack you up. Really important if you, you know, have reasons to crack up in the morning. I've been doing this for years. I just do something silly in the morning and it cracks me up. No end. and it works for me. Because 2021, energetically speaking, is actually a year of pleasure. A year of joy, which we so badly need. Now, that doesn't mean that the governments of this world won't continue scaremongering, you know, rolling out vaccinations and scaring the shit out of people, right? Or coming up with new restrictions. Who knows? The point the guides are making is, even though you may not be able to change what a country, let's just say, imposes on you, within all that, you can make an awful lot of change. And they're saying to you, the higher your energy is, the more joy you feel. And 2021 will support that. This is a year of joy. So it's like, yeah, and we got this. And so the energy will be reflecting that very idea of having fun, having joy, having pleasure, because that creates high energy. And the higher the energy, the easier it is to make changes, to bring changes to the life we're all living, or to the lives we're all living, right? So the reason why this is a bit vague is because everything is always in flux. So when people say like, oh, that's definitely what's going to happen in 2021, my experience is that you can never really say like, that's definitely what's going to happen, because you also have free will. You could personally decide against it, if that makes sense. So this is overall energy. And again, within it, you'll have to see what's going on. It will be much clearer. We'll get much clearer, I suppose, when we look at the individual star signs anyway, when we look at, you know, what's going on there. But let's just have a look at certain things for 2021. And people somehow, you know, somehow seem to be really interested in their businesses. Oh, I want to be more successful, and I get that. But success is a weird thing in that it doesn't necessarily define you. What it probably brings you is this financial stability and maybe allows you to do what you want to do. And that's all good, and we're going to look at this. But energetically speaking, it is much more important that you, as a spiritual being trapped in a body, so to speak, have a sense of belonging and a sense of being loved. So let's just look at what 2021 holds for us on an emotional level, with regards to being loved, right? So we have the totem, the dove, and the cat. Interesting, because remember, in the beginning of this video, the guides were saying that new portals are opening and that it is important that you make it your own. And totem, for want of a better word, means family, means tribe. So 2021 is the year, and this is awesome, where you will find your tribe, and where, should you have already found it, relationships within your tribe are much better, which also means that relationships on a love level will get much more solidified, which is really, really good. And there's a couple of interesting things because you have the dove and the cat. So what they're, oh, this is again, you have free will, that's why I see this as a suggestion. But it's based on the fact that the energy supports that. Because we have the dove and the cat with regards to love and being loved and belonging somewhere, right? Be peaceful. Don't argue, because it's a difference between speaking your mind, speaking your truth, expressing yourself, and getting irate and angry and upset about it, which ultimately lowers the energy a little. Well, if an argument is heated, or even a conversation is heated, energy always suffers a bit. But what they're saying is, in 2021, just pay attention to your energy at all times, and because we're talking about love and being loved and the feeling of, how do I keep this up? How do I make sure that the person I love is supported by me, and the person I love or the people I love support me? And this may or may not be surprising to some of you because we have the cat. And what they're saying is, in any relationship, and that includes work, but we're not talking about work now, we're talking about love. In any relationship, it is important that you remain yourself. And because you have the cat, what they're saying is, do your own thing as well, right? Make time for relationships. I also have the feeling we have to sort of, in a way, prioritize our relationships. So it's not that you can just do whatever the heck you want. Well, you could, but you do whatever the heck you want, and then you wonder why the relationship is falling apart. So they're asking you to pay attention to the needs, if that makes sense, of the relationship. Maybe it is important that the people or the partner you're with needs a bit more of your time, right? So give that. At the same time, the cat is basically saying to you, if you are a person that has a hobby, if you are a person that works spiritually, and therefore, or even if you work as anything, that is sort of your thing, sort of self-employed, or if you work for the betterment of people, society, all that kind of stuff, you will need time to look at what you're doing, come up with new ideas, all these kind of things. So what the guides are saying is, be the cat. Remove yourself at times. And because this is your energy for the year, your partner will very likely or should really do the same. And you can expect them to understand that you can't sit 24/7 every single day with them on the couch and cuddle, as nice as this is, because you have a life to live. And there are certain times in your life where the way you plan your life and the things you do in life may not meet the interests of your partner. And so this is not about compromising. This is about saying, like, okay, this is what I enjoy doing as well, and just make space for this, and be upfront about it. Don't try to hide something, and don't try to don't let this become an issue, if that makes sense. But it is important that you have a little bit of, well, actually, because we have to get more than just a little bit of self-sustained me time within your relationships, right? Okay, so that's really That's really what it is for 2021 with regards to love. We quickly go into work and business and all these kind of things. My feeling is I don't want to do half an hour just on the overall energy, because that can be tedious in the fact that it is much more interesting to you if we look at your star sign and what it will bring month by month by month. But it is important to overall see if there's actually opportunities coming or not. So we're looking at opportunities for 2021 with regards to anything that is related to work and income and all that kind of stuff. And what the guides are saying to you is that you ought to balance spirituality and practicality. So you are a spiritual person and new opportunities will come to you because your energy is powerful, is awesome, but you have to also learn to realize that sitting under a tree doing hugging 25,000 trees is awesome, but it doesn't sustain you with regards to, you know, paying rent and all that kind of stuff. And what they're saying is, but balance it out. Best case scenario, and this has always been my take on it, because I've had this life where I worked in many massively big companies, and then I've been full-time self-employed since 2009. Before that, I was part-time self-employed, if that makes sense. But since 2009, I haven't been doing anything else but what I came here to do. So I feel incredibly blessed, and that's what the guides are saying, is if you find it difficult to balance out spirituality and practicality, then 2021, because this is one of the opportunities that they're talking about, is the year where if you focus on, that's what I want to do, I want to be that person, I want to be me, then that's what the guides will support. And then we have, and this is interesting, surrender to the divine says it all. Trust that there is no coincidence. Trust that your life has purpose. Trust that there's guides around you that help you with everything. So don't get too upset about things. There will always be a million and one ways to tweak things and to get somewhere. But with regards to opportunities that lead to a more secure life, if that makes sense, what the guides are saying is surrender to the divine. Opportunities will arise. Look at them for what they are. And first and foremost, remember we're living in a world where a lot of people really, unfortunately, are not all that awake. They don't feel themselves, don't understand what is out there in the universe that could help them. They don't ask for guidance, they don't ask for help, and you are a person that has that down to a T. And so what the guides are saying is, you're not here to save everybody. Even if you do spiritual work for a living, you can only offer. If people take it, that's fine. If they ultimately are not there yet, there's not much you can do or should be doing, because people have to be ready before they take that journey, if that makes sense. And all you can do is provide that lifeline that gets them there. So that's what 2021 is energetically. What I'm getting is, before we sort of close down the overall energy and go into your individual year, is to realize that spirituality, being the best version you can be, is exactly what is needed for 2021. And I believe, based on the energy that I'm getting, this is really about a counterbalance, creating a counterbalance to all the things that are happening in the world. You know, everybody, I think the only topic really in 2020 was bloody COVID, right? And all that kind of stuff, which obviously puts a big damper dampener on all of us. And then look at how many businesses have suffered because of it. Look how many restrictions there are. People become more isolated and have become more isolated, which is not good, if that makes sense. And that's what the guy said earlier. Tribe. You will find your tribe, and you are part of the tribe. And so you, with your high energy, allow your tribe to do more than they were able to previously. So overall, the energy of 2021 is really high, and it's a kick-ass energy. It's like do energy. It's not a do or die energy, but it's an energy where they're saying, like, you know, we're sending you opportunities, but if you're going to sit there, I can't see them. Yeah, well, then you can't see them, right? Be proactive. Be out there. Have high energy, right? Do things. And doers always do best, okay? So that was the overall energy. Remember, you will see this little clip in all the 12 videos for the star signs, because the overall energy applies to all star signs, therefore never changes, right? So, okay, that was that. And now we're looking into your own month-by-month breakdown, for want of a better word, of your individual star sign. Yeah, let's do that. Hello, Leos. How are you doing? So, we're looking at your year 2021, month by month, starting with January 2021. Let's have a look what the universe has lined up for you guys in 2021. Excuse me, this is your January. Here we go. Right, for Scorpios in January, what the guides are saying is for you to remember that you are not alone. And again, I said that in many of these annual videos here, that the universe wants you to know you're not alone. There are guides around you. Your so-called star brothers and sisters are around you. So you're not alone, because in January 2021, they're asking you, Scorpios, to reflect on, are you angry or even pissed off? Are you annoyed? Do you feel people took advantage of you, or you were too lenient and you waited for opportunities and they weren't happening because people weren't putting the weight, kind of stuff? So if this is your feeling of feeling like, oh, you know, all the guys are saying is in 2021, January, please let it go, because it does not serve you to hang on to these feelings and emotions. Probably a good idea to have a good cry, because that helps a lot. Excuse me. And let it all go. That's the only job you have in January 2021, is to reflect on how you truly feel and let it go. Okay? Short and sweet. For January 2021, we're in the star sign of Scorpio. Let's have a look. Yeah. Come February, things are already on the up for you guys. For Scorpios in February, you have the River Otter and the Wolverine. As you know, I work with animal guides, spirit animal guides, and Native American guides. And I also have some starseed cards here and my trusted Moonology cards and whatever deck I'm drawn to, because each deck has their own specific guides attached to them. That's what I'm going to look at. For February, you have two animal guides, namely the Wolverine and the River Otter. And what they're saying to you is, if, because they asked you to begin the year reflecting on how you feel. And in February, they're asking you not to lower your energy by thinking, it's all very difficult still, right? Because the energy, remember, you hopefully watched the over energy before this part, never skip it. Because whatever happens in this part, you know, your monthly help that the guides give you, the overall energy is really important to realize, oh, that's what's happening here, energetically speaking, right? and then make more informed choices. What the guides are saying to you in February, you know, simple. They want you to realize how much progress you have made in your life. And they're asking you to remember that sometimes when you're annoyed and when you feel it's all too much, you're letting things go, which was what the guides asked you to do, let things go that don't work. But at the same time, sometimes it isn't a bad idea to hold on to some things, especially if they're underneath of it all. It's a lot of love, right? And a lot of feeling like, okay, maybe we just didn't do this right. So that's what I'm getting for February, is for you to hold hands with people that probably need your guidance a little bit without becoming their carer, if that makes sense. You know, don't give your 100% over to someone and then don't look at your life. That's not what the guys are asking you. But they're asking you to not just wildly make space for new things, because as always, people are being sent to you so they can learn from you or you can learn from them. And my feeling for Scorpios in February is that there are still people who have a lot to teach. And all the guides are saying is, don't be so quick in dismissing them. Okay? So as you can tell already, we're only 2 months in. This is all about letting go and making space for new things without being too over the top. Okay? Going into March 2021, we're looking at the star sign of Scorpio. I have a new phone holder, right? I mean, I've been doing all these videos. I think that we're easily into our 80s. This, I think, is the 83rd video or something with regards to energy reading. So every now and then I get bored of always seeing the same stuff. So, you know, I buy all sorts of things to make things look more interesting. And I bought this. It's like a hand that holds the phone. And you flip it on its head, so it stands on its thumbs like this, and then the phone goes in. The point I'm making is, it's not the most flattering, because it sort of goes like this. I think I can just tell that my midriff here, right, isn't all that charming. Doesn't matter, you know, you have to try out new things, and so that works quite well though when I see it here or not, right? So all I'm saying is, I'm trying out new things, new angles to make this a bit more interesting, because remember, all you have to go through here, you poor people, it's a monologue, and it's, even though it is information for you, it's still a monologue. And I have worked in radio for many, many years, so I know that it is very hard to stay tuned into monologues. That's why I have a lot of guests, and I'm still looking for guests. Do you understand that? Really, really important. So just want to share this with you, that this is the first time I'm using this holder, so it may not be perfect yet. Okay? In March 2021, for the star sign of Scorpio, you are still healing, and they're asking you to keep healing, right? Look at your healing. And in March, what they're saying to you, I'm just seeing if I can phrase this better. What the guides ask you to do is to remember and to realize in March, yes, I'm still flooding out old stuff. I'm still healing, if that makes sense. And in March, they're asking you simply to be loyal to yourself. The feeling that I'm getting is that 2021 is trying to kick in for Scorpio, and yet your energy feels quite burdened. And what the guides are trying to do is to get this all out. And then some of you Scorpios actually don't want to be reminded of their shit. You just want to move on. And all the guides are saying is, don't do that, because you have learned to carry all that stuff with you, which is why you probably don't trust, which is why a lot of stuff doesn't work. So what they're saying to you in 2021, do yourself a favor and look at your healing that presents itself and let it all out. There will be a lot of tears. Tears are sacred medicine, so that's all good. There's no weakness in dealing with your traumas and your pain. And in March, they're saying to you, all you got to do, really, is to be loyal to yourself. So don't give in to people's demands, because you know people keep on coming when you're a giver, and in March they're saying to you, you need some me time. Okay, right. That was March 2021 going into April 2021 for the first time. Now I'm looking at my moonology deck. Oh, it's even better. Yeah. Not even talking about the decks. They're different decks. It's just sort of my stuff that I'm working with here. Remember what they said to you in March. Be loyal to yourself and allow yourself to heal. And it makes perfect sense, because April 2021, a new start is coming. New things can come. And what the guys are trying to say to you, do to you, help you with, is the more you let go, the lighter you are, the more they can fill you with new and exciting and uplifting and spiritual experiences. And that's what they're trying to do. So in April, a new start is coming, but they're asking you again, bloody hell, they're asking you again, Scorpios, to bring love into the situation. The feeling that I'm getting is there's a lot of frustration about the star sign of Scorpio still in 2021. And I know a few Scorpios, so I know they can be quite uplifting, but I also know that when you have issues, you unfortunately often procrastinate or just, you know, don't do nothing. And it's a difference of doing nothing and doing nothing while healing, right? Really, really important. If you take me time, don't just take me time. Take me time and say, like, okay, I acknowledge it. I don't want to feel that way. I want to feel happier. Let's see where I'm going. So that's another thing that the guides remind me of a lot thus far. So they're asking you in April, bring love into the situation. Bring your kinder side to proceedings. And that will help with the progress of the year. Right? So that was your April. Good. Going into May 2021. We're looking at the star sign of Scorpio. What can I say? The year 2021 for Scorpio, apparently, we're already in May, is all about letting go of what has happened to you over a lifetime. And my suspicion is that it's probably even more than one lifetime. There seems to be older trauma at work here. So sorry. It is what it is, guys. So, for 2021, what they're saying is there's a lot of frustration still. This is all, the whole year seems to be about healing. And in May, they're saying to you is, don't make the mistake to hide again from your true emotions. Don't. You still need rest in May, right? Not really, really important. You still need some rest in May. So, allow yourself some time to recover from the things that happened in your life. Also, I have to say this. This feels like your life is dreadful. It isn't. What the guides are saying to you is, because you are always, or you know, a lot of times anyway, busybodies, and you just do and you just give to others, you may not take the time to stop and say, like, okay, where am I in this? How do I truly feel? And that's what the guides have in store for you for 2021. Because your other animal here is the deer, right? And the deer, sort of, the idea is that it functions best at sunrise and sunset. So don't have anyone chase you during the day. Don't do 10 million things. And rest. Have a really good rest. Make sure that your days and the time you spent is well-paced, right? So pace yourself right. Allow yourself some time out. Really, really important. Right? Because as you can see, we're in May and they really haven't changed topics yet. This is all about healing, 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 right? And new opportunities, even though they said to you that there's new starts coming, a new start is coming in April, you're sometimes your own worst enemy and you can be in the way, right? So that seems to be the case and the scenario for 2021. Now going into June 2021. Perfect. See? I like it.
because we just talked about it, and about not procrastinating and you know. So come June, what they're saying is now is the time to be bold and make the first move. So the hope is that by June, you have let a lot of pain run through your system, right? So you are lighter now. And in June, they're saying, well, now you are a bit lighter. Be bold and make the first move. And first and foremost, hold your vision. Whatever you felt or feel like, oh, that's what I want to achieve this year, right? Be focused and go for it. So June is going to be one of those kick-ass months where whatever you manifest, and the more pushy, without being frightening, but the more pushy you are, the more you say, like, no, this is what I came here to do, the better this works, okay? Perfect, perfect, perfect. So June seems to be a little bit of a shift in the energy. Ah, it's even better. See, and in July, you have the mountain goat. And the mountain goat is an animal that hangs on two legs on a cliff and doesn't fall. So the analogy is that, you know, you look at this animal and it's on top of the world. And even though it hangs there on two legs, not bothered, doesn't fall. So in July, a lot of stuff that you were hoping for, provided you take the time to heal, right, is coming into fruition, right? So come June and July then, you know, things are really on the up. And they're asking you also, because you have the red fox here, to remember that you are an old soul. So should there be stumbling blocks, I think is the word, they're there for you to overcome them. And all the guides are saying is you have been in so many situations that you have overcome. This time won't be different, right? But June and July are really good months for Scorpios, especially with regards to anything your heart desires. So this is not just work. This is also where you can be a little bit bolder to make your feelings known when it comes to love, right? Might as well, you're addicted to love. Okay, well, that's all good. Going into August, we're looking at the year of 2021 and the star sign of Scorpio. This is your August 2021. Here we go. Looks like they have loads of stuff to say because there's loads of animals falling through, coming through here. Okay. Right. August. Interesting. You have the kingfisher. You have the heron, the peacock, and the crow. In August, they're saying to you, you have made so much progress. And because they talked about the red fox and saying overcoming stumbling blocks in July, in August, they're saying to you, no matter what life throws at you, do not slow down. Everything and anything will work fine. Hold your vision. Keep going for the things you really, really want. That's really, really important for you to do that. And also, even though they're asking you to be focused, the heron is the next animal here that you got, is a bird that stands in the water all day. And when the fish comes, he goes like, thank you. And he does it on one leg, by the way. So again, the analogy is for you that things will come to you. You can be light-footed. You can be light-hearted. New opportunities will come your way and you will notice them when you're focused. Stay focused, hold your vision, and you just take it. So it's not that you have to be overly stressed out about things in August. Really, really important. The other thing that the guides are saying to you in August, you have the peacock. And the peacock sometimes says, I'm fine, when he's not. If that makes sense, because he has this beautiful wheel. And for people saying, oh my God, it's really beautiful. Every time I come here, he puts it up for me so I can photograph him. They think they're well-trained. They're not well-trained. This wheel is designed to keep predators at bay because all the predators are seeing is about 1,000 eyes. They're like, bloody hell, I better don't attack this guy because there might be more than one of these guys. So, and the analogy, again, is that you sometimes outwardly project, all good, I'm awesome, yeah, let's do this. And all the guides are saying to you is that is not a good thing to do, because if you can't even tell people when you're stressed and that you have to pace yourself, remember, that's not a good thing. So don't go into acting, right? Because in August, you're still going through a lot of change. There's a lot of change coming your way. And And change is good because, as you have seen, June, July, August, it's all about new things because now you're lighter. You know, let's go for new things. And if you go for the same things because you like doing them, right? If you still say like, well, I've been creating this business and I want this to flourish, or I've been in this loving relationship and I want this to flourish, yeah, you can do that, you know, but also allow for changes to happen because that's how you ultimately grow, right? So that was your August. We're looking at the star sign of Scorpio. No matter what I sometimes say, my brain isn't always with it. Scorpio, this is the year 2021. Going into September. In September, you have two wildcats. You have the puma and the jaguar. And this is about realizing how well you adapt to situations. And they're asking you, yes, there may be, this may still be the time where you have to adapt to situations because you need other people's help. And you probably want to be part of a group, or even if you're self-employed, just let's say, and, you know, spiritually self-employed, you still need venues if you want to do something with a lot of people. So you still need to negotiate with people. And all the guides are saying is, you know, in order to do that, you have to be at your highest. And so you have the Jaguar as well. And the Jaguar is saying to you, like, you are unique. Don't hide your uniqueness. It is much better to not hide your uniqueness, because he has the puma, which is the animal that is also known as the mountain lion. So the idea is that he's called different names in different places. It means you adapt very well to situations. And all they're saying is, as good as this is in September, to remember that you can adapt to changes very well. Always be you. My feeling is for Scorpio that in 2021, your true north, your true self will emerge. It's quite a powerful year energetically. It's just because there are so many things you still carry with you that the universe needs to remind you that they're still there, right? That was September. Going into October 2021, we're looking at the star sign of Scorpio. Let's have a look. Yeah, we just talked about it. You will notice that sometimes the guides say something and then the next month just confirms it, if that makes sense. In October, what the guides are saying to you is nothing is yet set in stone, right? Don't expect for things to be, yeah, that's the way to go. That's what we're going to do. That works, right? Everything is still a bit in flux and not set in stone, which means you can be unique, if that makes sense. And you don't have to overly adapt to situations. And all what they're also asking you in October, because now you have had a lot of experience in 2021 with high energy. Now what they're saying to you is, see, you have tasted success. And I get the feeling this is as much about your so-called business ventures as it is about your love life. So if you are a Scorpio that of now has, whenever you watch that video, hasn't found Mr. or Mrs. Right, or says, I'm happily single, they can all F off, as you do, what the guides are saying to you is, you deserve to be loved, and there's always someone out there who would like to love you just the way you are. And if you have acknowledged all your feelings and all your pain in the earlier months of the year, you know, you will be more than capable and ready to embrace a new love. That doesn't mean that you don't have a new love in October, because the idea is, I record this in December 2020, is hopefully to watch this at the beginning of 2021, right? And then just make mental notes or whatever you do, right? Because that's what the guides want you to do, is to get help. All they're saying is, in October, they're saying to you as well, step out of your comfort zone. And my feeling is, because they're highlighting love, it's also important to step out of your comfort zone there. Same thing if you are in a long-term relationship. You know, we learn to live with a lot of things. You know, they learn to live with a lot of things. Like, okay, well, he or she has got, you know, Scorpio, has got quite some issues here, but I can live with it because I love him. and vice versa. It's all give and take. That's just the name of the game. And all the guides are saying is, come October, they're asking you to just gently, as always, talk about it. You know, if there's something that you feel like, you know, this isn't really helping us here, maybe there is another way of doing these things. And if you are with someone that you can trust, they shouldn't be close-minded when you just say, like, you know, I want to talk about this, right? So communication is important. That's your October. Step out of your comfort zone a little. And that's the important thing. So, talking for England again. Going into November 2021. Here we go, Scorpios. You have the wolf and the seahorse. So what they're saying to you in November, you are fully in charge of everything in November. You have made all your points. It is really, really important. And yet, you may still feel stuck in some areas. And the guides are asking you, unstuck yourself. Right? So that's really important to see, like, okay, how come I do all these things and I have all these, you know, successes and, you know, and people like my ideas and I can feel what I do helps others and it's just great, you know. And all the guides are saying is there's a part of you that is still stuck and it's time to realize, because you have the seahorse and they're really, you know, intelligent little beings, but 90% of them die in captivity. So they're quite sensitive, right? I mean, it's just a number kind of thing, you know. But the analogy, again, is for you to realize if there's something that makes you stuck, you're not doing so well with it. And again, so what the guides are saying is always sounds easier said than done because they're not living your life. They're just advising you on it, you know. Unstuck yourself. My feeling is that it is all about communication. Talk. Don't argue. Don't be aggressive. Don't be loud. For whatever reason, I prepare these videos and for whatever reason, I thought like, oh, yeah, let's put another one-liner in. And what came to me in the beginning of the second part, which is the part we're doing now, I put in that something about a scorpion that said the smaller the scorpion, the more venom it has, right? So you do not have to inflate your ego to be hurt, right? Because the larger the scorpion, the less venom he has. So it's like, wah, right? So what they're saying is you are yourself, right? Even if at times you feel a bit smallish, you have plenty of poison if anyone is trying to mess up your life, even though that's not the case for scorpions. And no animal in the world wastes his poison. So they're not bad beings. They use it when they feel like, bloody hell, I'm really in trouble here. You understand that? What the guides are saying to you in November, because they remind me of the one line that I put in there, is for you to sort of realize that if you're not well, your only weapon is to make it known. But what they're asking you, because that's what we just talked about, you know, having venom, is to not waste your venom. Please look into how you communicate. Is there still frustration left that the guides were asking you in January to begin to let go? Is this just a pattern that you have, that you just lose your cool? If so, please, please, please work on it, right? So that's your November 2021, going into the last star sign of the year. Last star sign, I mean the last month, obviously. December, bloody awesome months for Scorpio, because again you have the doll's sheep, another sheep like the mountain goat, even though sheep and goats are not the same, but another animal that hangs on two legs on a cliff and is perfectly happy there, right? So what the guides are saying is in December, if you reflect on your life, you will notice that there were a lot more things that went right than things that went wrong. So, you know, count your blessings, be a little grateful, I suppose. And remember, again, in December, you have the Grey Fox, which means, you know, you are an old soul. You have been here before. And they're asking you to realize that you will always be supported. And even when you feel like, well, who the hell is supporting me, right? You are still supported by your guides and by the universe. And in the case of Scorpio, because they're stressing this here with me, to say that to you, for the whole year of 2021, even though we're now in December, communication is the key. You know, make sure you are not in any case irate when you communicate, right? And make sure that you come across gently and gentle, right? Yay, that was your year 2021. That's all we have time for, Scorpios. Have a good one. Bye.